Hello Aries, welcome at your reading for May. It is a beautiful reading. And why? Because we have a beautiful number for you, and it's number one. In numerology, I counted all the cards for you, and that's the Magician. So in May, you can now do what you had manifested in your mind in April. Because the April season in Aries was meant to be to get a clear mental vision. What do I want to manifest in May? Now, the challenge is to do it in a slow pace. Because I'm an Aries, always wants to do things faster than the world spins. And we are not allowed in May. We have to take it slow, and we have to look at our shadow sides. And the obsidian, the black obsidian, will help us. It's also called Apache Tears. It is found in the area where the Americans slaughtered the Indians, and the stone was found there in that area. They use it, the Indians use it also as a mirror, and we can use it as a mirror for the subconscious to transform the sides of us who aren't conscious enough. When we are afraid of the world, when we are afraid of our own feelings, we're gonna stuff it inside. But that will produce disharmony and illnesses and weaknesses and distortions. And that is also what the cards are telling me. It's the devil. Don't be afraid of the devil, because it's a card of transformation. And the rabbit. And the rabbit is very afraid of the eagle. But when he is telling the universe, I'm afraid of the eagle, I'm afraid of the eagle, the eagle's gonna eat me, ooh, I'm afraid of the eagle. Yes, then he's gonna manifest what he doesn't want. When you are worrying about things, you are praying for the things you don't want. So be very aware of your thoughts in May, because when you are afraid, anxiety is a very good emotion, but you have to use it well. If you are walking on the highway and you have anxiety, then it's really useful, because it helps you to survive. But when you're not aware what your mind is thinking, then you have a big problem. So be aware, use a black stone, an obsidian, to transform the things in your life where you're most afraid of. Are you afraid to be lonely? Are you afraid to be successful? Are you afraid to be overweight? In my House of Inner Health, I'm consulting and advising a lot of people with intermittent fasting. It's a very scientific based method to lose weight, and I love it. I use it for almost 7 years now on myself and my family and my friends and my clients, and it's a beautiful tool to lose weight, to be healthy, but also to be energetic and be very clear-minded. So be clear-minded, my dear Aries. Over here, and this is very soothing, you have the wands, two, and you have from the crown tarot the wands, three. So, what you thought about in April, what you wanted to do, now you can manifest in the Taurus season in May. So, take a step back, and that's all the action you need, because you're already there. The universe is already on your side. You only have to align with the universe. And I counted your cards, and the overall number in numerology is one. So you're the magician, and you can manifest and allow yourself to create things you really want. But you have to have a clear vision. I'm an Aries also. I'm impatient. And I'm very curious, and I want to manifest everything at the same time, and then you get fragmented. So you have to take it slower. And this is also a beautiful card that I it's an angel card. Let me read it out loud for you. Organization. Your plans are on target, and everything will flow more smoothly if you add a little organization and discipline to your methods. The key to success is to allow your creativity to be gentle, guided by logic. Be open to asking for help from someone very intellectual, or seek out a mentor. I think that's beautiful. I have a lot of clients who are coming to me and they're asking me, Mabel, can you please help me to look at my business, to look at my marriage, to look at my kids, to look at my health, to look at my overall well-being. And I will do that with coaching tools like NLP and neuro-linguistic programming and AFT, emotional freedom technique, but also I'm a psychic, but also I have a clairvoyance ability. So I will look in depth at everything. And that's an honor for me to be able to guide so many people on such different disciplines. And it's my strength, but it's also my weakness, because I can do a lot of different things, and I think that is the same for Aries, a lot of Aries. They are talented and they're creative, but they are also impatient and they want to do everything at the same time, and I think it's really funny. But it's also a challenge to be focused. So I ask you, please be focused, write down your goals for May, really structured, and maybe in an Excel sheet, or ask help. And you're also welcome at Skype or FaceTime, or you can ask me to make a video for you and I will send it to you by email. So ask help, don't be shy, or don't be too proud to do so. I take English lessons every week, because it's a wish, a long time wish for me to speak it fluently. And I think it's always really beautiful when I see people who want to be a student forever, and I'm a student forever. Maybe that's why you're looking at my tarot blogs, because you want to study life, you want to study yourself, you want to excel in your life, and you want to find inner peace. And I think it's beautiful that we can share that wish together. And this is from Aleister Crowley. It's the cup 4. And it's prosperity. Your cup runs over in May. But you have to allow yourself that you're already there. You're already there. You only have to organize it. You only have to ask for help. And that's sometimes the most difficult thing to do. But I have a lot of faith in you, Aries. And I sent you all my love, my pink love. But your color is black this month, with a light touch of pink. I sent you all my love. And I hope to see you next month in June.